Hi guys, it's Ans Britannia, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a tropical formicarium for your ants. So guys, to make this formicarium, you're obviously going to need to buy a few bits of materials. So I went to my local pet store, and my local pet store is called Pets at Home. Some of you guys in the UK might know the pet store. This is where I purchased. That's where I purchased this tank here. It only cost £15, so it's not too bad. It's waterproof, which is perfect for a tropical formicarium because there's going to be a lot of humidity. And I am actually going to be creating a small kind of pond or lake in this formicarium. I also bought some substrate, some sand for the formicarium, for the pond. And I've also got some kind of soil left over from when I did my trapdoor formicarium. I also purchased a hygrometer. I think that's how you pronounce it, but the hygrometer basically measures humidity in the formicarium, which is essential when keeping tropical ants because you want to make sure you have the correct humidity for the type of ant species that you have. So yeah, I went to my local garden centre. That's basically where you can buy plants here in the UK. And I don't know the specific names for these plants. This is called a Fittonia, but I know it will hopefully look quite nice in the tropical formicarium that I'm planning to make. I actually keep a couple of Fittonias in my house here, and they are very strong, and out of all the plants I've kept, they tend to grow the quickest and they have survived through everything. They are very tough plants. I also purchased some gravel. Now the gravel's in this kind of blue sieve here. The gravel came in a small kind of pack. It's more like aquariums, but it came in like a small pack, and I soaked the gravel in this container here over 24 hours overnight, and in some water, and then I proceeded to rinse the gravel under some water. This is essentially just to get rid of any kind of dust that may be sitting on top or around the gravel. I don't really want that in the formicarium. I want to keep the water as clear as possible in there and as clean as possible. I'm also going to use some of this cocoa brick. I used, as you can see, half of it's gone. It's because I used half of it in my trapdoor ant formicarium. If you guys haven't seen my trapdoor ants, I'll leave a link below in the description. I made a nice little video showcasing their arrival and how I kind of set up their formicarium. If you guys are planning on keeping an exotic species of ant, that might be a good kind of starter video for you to watch, but this will help you out if you want to create your tropical formicarium. So guys, we're gonna start by adding in our base layer of gravel. Now, this will hold the water quite well at the bottom of the tank, because sometimes if you just put in soil or sand at the bottom, and then add a lot of moisture, it can create some kind of mold and compressed mud at the bottom of the tank, which can smell rather bad. So don't tend to want that. So it's good to create a small base layer of gravel. Then I'm gonna lay over a small sheet of plastic, which has a few holes in it. This will keep the rocks separated from the sand and soil. It will keep most of it separated. It will just allow good separation of the substrates. I don't really want any kind of sand or soil slipping through the cracks in the rocks and creating that mud at the bottom. But let's get cracking, guys, and let's get creating. Okay, we're gonna try and do this now without making an absolute mess. But I'm gonna try and try and just layer this here at the bottom here. Now, as some people may know who have aquariums, I have like a little aquarium you can see behind me. If you guys want to see a small kind of video of my aquarium, just let me know in the comments if you want to see the kind of fish I've got. But as some people may know, with aquariums, you tend to make the back of the tank reasonably high, and then you put the back of the tank high and make the front of the tank, where you've got the most visibility, quite low. This creates like a sense of depth in the tank and makes it look bigger than it actually is. So I'm going to try and repeat the same process with my Formicarium here. I will try and create the pond, the front of the tank, which is usually, hopefully, be the lowest point, the lowest part of the tank itself. So guys, I've created a kind of foundation layer. This is about a centimetre deep. So now I'm going to start shaping the gravel of the land as to the landscape I want to create. So guys, I've kind of got the back end of the tank sorted. So where the pond is going, I'm just going to create a small opening at the front here. Okay guys, now we've got all of our gravel in place where we want it. So as you can see, there's a slight slant in the tank where the back of the tank is a lot higher than the front of the tank. And I've created just a small semicircle at the front of the tank where it's at its lowest, where I plan to create a small pond. Okay guys, next step, I cut out some plastic from a packet that was around some blue rolls, some toilet rolls, and I'm gonna layer this around over the top of most of this gravel, even the bottom of the pond, just to separate the substrates. Try and make it invisible around the sides, because you don't really wanna see bits of plastic around the side of the tank, so I'm going to try and center it a little. Now we've added in our plastic kind of sheeting over the top of our gravel. Now I'm going to proceed with adding in the sand for the pond, for the bottom of the pond. This will kind of give it a more naturalistic feel, and sand has really good filtration. It can filter into the rocks quite well around the side and everything, so let's go ahead and add that in. I bought myself some desert sand. This is made by Pets at Home. It's their own brand. It's not fine. It's quite thick sand, which is good, because it means if the ants wish to move it about, they can. Sometimes the problem is with fine sand, it can get quite dusty, and ants will sometimes struggle to walk on it. The sand is very good for all kinds of Formicariums, because it has great contrast to all coloured kind of ants. Unless they're sand covered, of course. Okay, so I've got the sand now where I want it, just around the basin of the pond. And as you can see here, I've placed the sand at the front of the tank. Right guys, now it's time to add in our soil. I'm going to add this around the sand, around the edges here. Okay, so I'm going to be adding in some plant soil first. So this is some houseplant compost. This is specific for these kind of like houseplants. These kind of plants that I'm going to be putting in the Formicarium, and this compost will have the required nutrients and minerals for those plants to grow successfully. If you guys are thinking about keeping live plants in your Formicariums, be sure to get the right soil specific for your plant. So guys, I've added in all the plant soil that I require, and as you can see here, very nice slant there where the back is a lot deeper than the front. This will obviously create some kind of depth in the Formicarium. Can't really be showcased at the moment because we don't have anything in the tank, but now I'm just going to go ahead and add a little bit more sand just to cover up this plastic here. So guys, I've added in some more sand and it's starting to look like a good foundation for a Formicarium here. It's good to add a variety of substrate, because then your ants can kind of choose, as well as know what temperature they like and humidity they like, they can also choose what material they like to build into. So here I've kind of given them a good choice between quite fine sand and quite thick soil. So it is completely up to them as to where they dig and build their nest. Now it's time to add our plants into our small formicarium here, and I'm going to try and repeat the same kind of process and keep the smaller plants towards the front of the formicarium and the large plants towards the back. So let's go ahead and add some of these plants here. I don't know the specific names of these plants. If you do know the names of these plants, to help people out, it would be fantastic if you wrote a comment in the comment section below, just letting people know what the plant is called. All right, let's add these plants in. I'm going to start by adding this petunia plant. Now, I didn't know it was called that. I just literally looked at the label on the plant. So let's give it a go. So guys, I think we're all done putting all the plants, and it's starting to look like a naturalistic tropical formicarium. And as you can see here, it looks absolutely beautiful. So guys, I'm extremely happy with the way things have turned out so far. So the kind of next step for me is to add some kind of rainforest litter on the top of the soil here to make it a bit more naturalistic for the ants. Okay, so I'm going to use some Exoterra rainforest substrate, hopefully give it that rainforest feel. Right, now we've got all of our substrate layers, we've got our gravel, we've got our plant soil, we've got our sand for our pond, and we've got our kind of rainforest litter on the surface of our soil here. And of course we've got our plants. So guys, this is the complete foundation of our tropical formicarium finished. So all we need to add now is just a little bit of water and a little bit of heat just to add that humidity. And then we are all done. So let's go ahead and add the water. I've got my water, and I've got this plastic kind of cut out piece of plastic here with a container which has a hole through the bottom of it. I am basically going to pour the water into that small container, and it's going to flood down through the hole. It's just so I don't disturb the substrate too much, because if I obviously pour this huge bowl of water into the formicarium, it might move the soil, might move the plants around, make it look a bit less attractive. So this is a good way of keeping all the substrate where you want it. Hopefully this doesn't go horribly wrong, but we're gonna find out. Oh. Oh. Maybe using the huge bowl is not a good idea. I'll be back with you in 2 seconds with a smaller bowl. Okay guys, so I managed to find this jug which is actually perfect for the kind of job that I need to do. Never use the wrong tools for the wrong job, obviously a lesson learned there by me. So guys, after adding in the last bit of water, we've finally finished our tropical formicarium. And if I don't say so myself, I'm extremely happy with the way this has turned out. It is truly a recreation of a tropical environment. So guys, that is pretty much how to make a tropical formicarium. I honestly hope this video helped any potential exotic ant keepers out there. When I first started keeping exotic ants, I didn't really have an idea of what to create, what to put them in, because obviously their environment is completely different to European environment. So if you're living in Europe or like the UK, like me, it is always a great idea to create your own little tropical setup like this. But if you're thinking of creating a nest to be attached to this, if you just want to use it as an outworld, I did make a little video on how to create a plaster formicarium. Plaster formicariums are usually really good. They have a good filtration, so the water will hydrate the nest really well. I'll leave a link below in the description if you want to check out that plaster nest video. It can come in handy. You wish to just make an additional nest for your ants. So guys, all I need to do now in terms of this nest is add a heat mat underneath. I'm going to add my hygrometer, the meter which detects humidity. I'm going to place it onto the glass, and Bob's your uncle, and I'm finished. It's been a pleasure making this small formicarium here, and it's been a pleasure showing you guys how to make it. It's not just been me showing you guys how to make something, I've learned a few things myself as well, so that's always great when you you learn something as well. So guys, I upload videos every single weekend. There's no specific day or time the weekend. It can just be, my video can just come up at any point at the weekend. If you find yourself liking this video, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Hit the bell button as well, because that will notify you when my video has been uploaded, because next week we are going to be moving a tropical ant species into this formicarium. Now that will be revealed in next week's video, so be sure to tune in for that. I hope you enjoyed this video, and have a great weekend, and I'll see you next week. And I also purchased a hygrometer, which measures humidity in the formicarium, which is essential if you want to... Scared the absolute...